I first saw Quatermass and the Pit under the title 5 Million Years to Earth on a double bill with a Viking Queen, because these pictures were not held in particularly high esteem in America, and they were mainly relegated to double bills. But I must say that when I was exposed to Quatermass and the Pit, I was a big fan of the previous two pictures, but this one had a depth, an intellectual depth, that the other pictures only hinted at, and was a pretty astonishing true science fiction movie. It wasn't all spectacle, it wasn't all special effects, and because of the low budget, some of the special effects actually are not really up to snuff in this picture, but the ideas behind it and the drama of the explanation of who the Martians are in real life and how we descended and from in our origins and how we came upon our ideas of the devil are real literary science fiction stuff. And some people have pointed out that on occasion some of this stuff could be seen a little earlier in Arthur C. Clarke's Childhood's End, which is one of those novels that was so brilliant when it came out that little pieces of it have been being taken from on other movies from years to years, and now it's almost impossible to make Childhood's End again because almost every aspect of it seems familiar to the audience because they've been recycled. After Quatermass and the Pit, Tobe Hooper made a picture called Life Force, which also is a kind of a recycling of the same themes. And so today the picture doesn't, I think, quite seem as shockingly different as it was when it was new. But it is still a remarkable achievement. And at this time, a director named Roy Baker was directing for Hammer, and he had started out as a British director. 20th Century Fox took him to America, and he made a number of American pictures, including one of Marilyn Monroe's best, Don't Bother to Knock, also one of the best 3D movies, Inferno, and probably the best picture he ever made was made back in England. It was A Night to Remember. It was the first Titanic movie, which some people believe is actually better than a certain other Titanic movie. But in any case, later in his career, he ended up working for Hammer, for whom this is the best picture that he made. He actually made some of his worst pictures at Hammer also. He made Scars of Dracula, which is the Dracula picture with the cheesy backcloths and the bats on strings. It's really the worst, I think, of the pictures. And also the very popular and successful Vampire Lovers, which was kind of an attempt to meld Hammer and American International type of pictures together in an experiment that only lasted one movie. But in any case, 5 Million Years to Earth, or Quatermass in the Pit, is, I think, one of the great science fiction pictures of the 60s. And certainly, if you haven't seen it, it's a gap in your knowledge that has to be filled.